Interview and job search strategies at work. This is a podcast that shares the secrets of getting a great IT job. I'm now interviewing an awesome person named Amanda Marino. Amanda, tell the audience about yourself.
All right, thank you so much. Thanks for inviting me. I'm Amanda Marino, just like Dan Marino, so you guys know who I am. I've been in recruiting for right at 10 years now. Mostly technology space is where I have spent most of my time, and I do a lot of IT recruitment nationwide. That's me in a nutshell. Right now I'm working for a firm based out of Washington, D.C., but I sit in New Orleans, Louisiana, and I fill jobs around the country. The firm's called Resolve It.
Awesome. How did you get started in your current role?
My current role, I've been with Resolve It now for some time, and, I got in this role and introduced to it just from my exposure to technology recruiting. And I mean, I think probably a more appropriate, how did I get into recruiting is, I kind of landed into recruiting, which was a great thing for me because of my brother. I have an older brother who is in the field, and he is a software developer.
Wow.
And so he's 4 years older than me. He's helped me throughout my whole life, and he's a software developer. And once I graduated college, he was like, Amanda, you should come work for the company that I work for. They have this HR job thing, and you might be really good at it. Just come apply. And that's what I applied for, an HR job thing. And then I found out it was recruiting, and I didn't even know there was a job for that. But all of a sudden, it all made sense. The company that I started out with took a chance on me, and it really was the best decision I've ever made. I became passionate about recruiting and about finding people and matching jobs, and it's been a profession that I happily fell into, but fell in love with as well.
Wow. So I guess you've answered the question, but I'll ask this anyway. What excites you most about your chosen profession that you're in?
So what excites me most, I love the people. I love that every day is different. I love the people that I get to interact with. I love being the person, and I know this sounds silly, but I like saving the day, a lot of times when I'm working with clients, they have this urgent need that, they need someone to help them build this application or solve this problem. And it's been sitting there and they haven't had anybody. And then I get to make that match with that perfect person who has, either haven't had the chance to get into a role like this, or maybe it's a step up in their career, or maybe it's somewhat seemingly a lateral transition that really promotes their career into a new trajectory. So it's the excitement of making the match and really helping people in their careers. That's what I love about it.
Wow. So just last question. Second to last question. Based on your experience, what advice would you give to someone who's working at McDonald's? They're trying to get into the IT field.
I think this is pretty cool because I feel like you could go a lot of different ways with this, right? What type of IT job do they want and all these different things. And really, at the end of the day, not only breaking into the field, but even once you're already into the field and you want to break into a new role, I believe it firmly boils down to be passionate about what you're doing. Now, if you're going back to the whole McDonald's, reference, or someone who's not in the field and wants to break in, anything entry level in most fields, but especially in technology, is super competitive. Because if you just think about it on a broad scale, one team can only pick on, X amount of entry level people because they have to teach you and guide you and bring you into their culture and their team. So the field is competitive trying to break in. And when you're interviewing and you're trying to get into a role, they know that you're junior, they know that you're breaking in, so they're not really leaning on what you know. I mean, obviously, that's going to be a big help. If you can show that you live and breathe tech, right? You know, you're doing side applications, you've done professional development on your own, and you have things to show them, that's all great. But it's going to be about how eager you are, how hungry you are, and your ability to interact and work with that team. I mean, that's what they're going to be looking for. They're going to be looking for your passion. Does that make sense?
Or? Yeah, perfect. Yeah, I love it. I love it. I completely understand. You know, yeah, you can't teach those soft skills, right? The personality. Yeah, it's awesome. I love it. So I just wanted to ask you, so how can people contact you? How can they reach out to you? So, you know, maybe you have a position and they can contact you. Tell us about how they can get in contact with you.
So I'm pretty easy to access. Quick way to get me is via email. My work email is amarino@resolve.com, and that's amarino@resolvit.com. So that's one way to reach me. You can always reach me on my LinkedIn as well. It's a pretty easy way to interact with me. I'm on that fairly often, and it's LinkedIn.com/AmandaGaspardMarino, and Gaspard is GASPARD.
Awesome. Wow, awesome. Amanda, I really appreciate you taking the time to teach us about just some strategies in the IT field, and you know, I really appreciate it. So yeah, thanks a lot, and look forward to talking to you again. Thanks.